How do you create snug fitting pieces for laser cut marquetry with little or no kerf adjustment? You lever the laser's idiosyncrasies instead of being frustrated by them. Hi, I'm Sarah Pike, artist and owner of FreeFall Laser and LearnLaserCutting.com. On this channel, I share a decade's worth of laser cutting knowledge to help you go from basic laser cutting to creating works of art. In this video, we're going to learn how to cut wood veneer for interlocking pieces that fit together snugly by addressing two issues: kerf loss that creates a gap between the pieces, and the fact that the laser cutter doesn't actually cut at a 90 degree angle. Instead of spending hours adjusting the file to solve these issues, we're going to use our understanding and find two ways to reduce the gap for little or no file adjustment. Stick around to the end for my bonus tip: which laser cutting setting should you adjust to get optimal accuracy when laser cutting for marquetry or inlay? The first issue we have to contend with is kerf loss. Kerf loss is the width of the material removed by the thickness of the cutting tool. With a saw, this is the thickness of the blade. With a laser cutter, it's the width of the laser beam plus the strength of the laser and the material density. This combination of beam width, laser strength, and material density is what makes determining kerf loss with a laser cutter different from a mechanical tool such as a saw or a CNC router, where the loss is uniform in thickness. With the laser cutter, the stronger the setting, the more heat is built up, leading to more material loss. Then we add the type of material and its density. When using the same setting, a denser wood like maple will experience less loss than a softer wood like pine. And ready for two more variables? If your design is intricate and small in scale, there is going to be more concentrated heat buildup, leading to more loss than if your design is larger. Curved areas in the design can experience more loss because the laser has to slow down to make those curves. The slower the laser removes, the more loss. While the laser cutter's computer code or G-code does adjust the power setting when it slows it down to balance things out, the increased loss can still be detectable when a snug fit is desired. All of these variables is why adjusting for kerf loss can be super frustrating. It isn't always as easy as offsetting the path in the file. Before we throw our hands up in frustration, let's take a look at the problem number two. Inside this problem is our solution for cutting snug fitting pieces. The second problem is that the laser cutter does not cut at a 90 degree angle, and this happens for two reasons. First, the shape of the laser beam is hourglass in shape. As it penetrates into the material, the beam goes out of focus and therefore is slightly weaker at the bottom. The beam is also hotter on the top of the material and cools as it penetrates, creating a cut that is slightly wider at the top than the bottom. While the difference is slight, combine this with kerf loss and the gap between your pieces becomes noticeable. So how do we leverage this? I've got two tips for you now and a bonus one at the end. The first trick is to cut the pieces top side down or jelly side down. Depending on the thickness of your material and the density of your veneer, this simple change in orientation will result in a hairline gap, eliminating the need for kerf adjusting in the file. The one place where you may need to adjust the file is with small inset shapes, or if one veneer is significantly denser than the others. In my work, I cut the pieces out, tape them together to identify which pieces need tweaking. This is far less time consuming and yields better results than adjusting or offsetting the pieces with the same kerf adjustment. This second tip is for working with thicker veneer when tip number one isn't cutting it. Alternate between cutting the pieces face up and face down. This creates a pseudo dovetail, nesting the pieces more snugly together. You still may need to adjust the kerf for some pieces. And I stress this, don't adjust the kerf on all of the pieces. It is more efficient and frustration reducing to adjust only the pieces that are face up or face down, not both. I know it goes against prevailing wisdom, but trust me, it works. Now for my bonus tip. This one has to do with optimizing the laser cutter settings to reduce kerf loss. The trick is to increase the PPI, or pulses per inch. Some laser cutters refer to this setting as frequency. It's counterintuitive, but when the pulses are closer together, there's actually less kerf loss because less strength is needed to break the bonds between the pulses. On my Universal laser cutter, I increase the PPI to 1,000, its highest setting, anytime I'm cutting for marquetry, inlay, or other types of interlocking pieces. And there we have it. We can outsmart the gap caused by kerf and reduce file adjustments by cutting wood veneer face side down or alternating the cut side to create a pseudo dovetail. And if you choose only one tip to take away from this video, choose the bonus one and increase the PPI for less kerf loss and a snugger fit for inlay, marquetry, or any project with interlocking pieces. If you found this video helpful, click the like button or subscribe for more tips on laser cutting, marquetry, and inlay.